Thanks for clicking on this Selenium tutorial. This is Bakkappa here. In this Selenium tutorial, I'll discuss how to implement soft assertion, and also I'll discuss the difference between soft assertion and hard assertion with an example. So at the end of this Selenium session, so you will get to know which type of assertion is right fit for your project. So I'll move on to the Eclipse IDE now. So you need to go and watch this tutorial. So I'm taking the same example which is discussed in this tutorial. So how to verify all the drop-down values. So simply I'll copy this class verify drop-down, then I'll paste it under the same package. So here I'm specifying the class name as soft assertion. So that's it. So I'll go to the class. So I'll explain the code what I have written. So in the first four lines, simply it opens the Chrome browser and it will maximize, and then it will enter the facebook.com. So after entering the facebook.com, so under the birthday, so it is getting all the values from this drop down list, and then we are comparing with the expected values. So here I have used the select class, so I have identified the drop down, then I'm getting all the values. If you look at this line number 26, so I have created the ArrayList object, then I'm adding each of the value from this particular drop down to the ArrayList. In the same way, I have created the expected drop-down values, then these are my expected values for the each of the drop-down values. Then in the next line, so I have used the for loop. So in this for loop, I'm taking the, based on the index, I'm getting the value from actual drop-down values, that is from the web page, and the expected drop-down values. So based on the index, I'm getting one value from the actually drop down values and the expected drop down values. Then I'm simply comparing here. So based on the true and false, so my assertion will get fail or pass, right? So simply I'll specify it as a NOV. So I'll execute this script now. So this will execute perfectly fine, and if you look at the script now, so it is launching the Chrome browser now, then it is entering the URL, then simply if you look at the result, so this is my actual value, so this is my actual value, and this is my expected value, so all the values are matching here from the web page and the my expected value which I have specified in the script. So currently what I have used, right? So this is the hard assertion. Let us say, so I'll specify here one expected value as a some test. So my script will get fail in this line. So rest of the assertion will not execute at all, right? So this is called the hard assertion. Let's go and execute this script. So this is the main difference between soft assertion and hard assertion. In case of hard assertion, whenever assertion fails, then and there the script will stop executing the next lines. If we go to the Eclipse IDE now, so it has compared till May only. So after that, it failed at the comparing the June value from the drop-down list, right? So next set of values, it did not compare at all, right? So this is where the soft assertion plays the major role. By using the soft assertion, you can go and compare the next set of values. Let us say in this drop-down list, it has compared till June. So next set of values, it did not compare at all, right? to achieve this, we need to use the soft assert. So let us discuss how to implement the soft assert now. So simply you need to create an object of the soft assert. Then simply I'll specify the reference for this. Then I'll use the new operator. So that's it. So I'll import the soft assert from the package org.testng.asserts. So that's it. I need to use the object of the soft assert by using this. So instead of assert, I'll replace with the soft assert object inside the this for loop. So that's it, guys. And after completion of this assertion, I will write one system.out.println all the assertion executed. And at the end, you need to use one more method by using this soft assert object. You need to call to the one more method called assert all. So that's it. So let's execute this program now. So previously it was failing at this line itself. So it was not at all comparing the next set of drop down values, right? So now we have implemented the soft assert and it will go and compare all the values from the drop down list, right? So I'll execute this test again. So now it has opened the browser, then it will enter the URL. Then if you go to the result, the console, see guys, so till it is executed till December. So actually our test got failed at this stage only, but still it is going ahead and it is comparing the next set of values from the this particular drop down list, right? So this is how we can implement the soft assert and hard asserts. So if you are not worried about the one of the assertion failure, if you want to check the other set of assertions, other set of verification, if you wanted to do in your project, I highly recommend you to go and implement the soft assert. And if some of the assertions are very important for the next set of verification, you need to use the hard assertion here. So that's all I have in this session. If you like this tutorial, click on like and also comment in the comment section if you have any feedback or views on my video, and also share with your friends and colleagues. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial.